We commissioned a study for quality of use business that was conducted by the immediate past president of the Florida Chamber Foundation. And that report showed conservatively that Florida businesses lose $392 million annually because of lost talent, replacement, all of the things that go into not being able to draw and retain top talent. And so we wanted to present you today with some speakers who can talk about what it means to have these policies and what it means to operate in the state where those protections exist in some places and not in others. I want to bring up now someone who's become such an important part of Quality Florida. Please join me in welcoming from PNC, Fred Livingston.
Good afternoon, everyone. You can hear me okay. I'm a little taller than most of the other speakers. I really want to start out by saying thank you to the Westin. I've lived in Florida for about 32 years, and I've been complaining just how hot it's been. We did not have that cooling trend at any point. So I walked in here, and I feel like I'm in a great long north. I'll be sleeping through this luncheon. So thank you so much for the kind opening comments, and thank you to Quality of Florida. Who just is tireless in their efforts and what they do. We were at the event last night in Broward County. They did a superb job. They've raised the bar, and then had the pleasure to be with you all today. But when I look at PNC and I look at diversity and inclusion, we talk about what's important and why do we do what we do. I was reviewing some notes in preparation for today's conversation, and I came across a number that really kind of struck me, and I had to validate it again this morning because I didn't believe what I saw. And the LGBT spend, the ability, the money that we have the disposal to spend on an annual basis is $884 billion. I checked the number, $884 billion, that was in 2014, and that can answer the question as to why. So why is PNC so devoutly committed to their diversity and inclusion? And clearly, when you look at that number, the business case sort of speaks for itself, but it's much more than that. We don't position ourselves committed to diversity and inclusion at PNC purely because of the dollars. We know we'll get there. We position because we really believe it's the right thing to do. And we have all along. And it started back in 2003 when we provided all the health benefits to all of our team members because we could attract and retain the right quality group. We're going to get some personal stories a little bit later in the presentation, just to kind of give you kind of an overview. Yes, it's the right thing to do. We spent a lot of time not only attracting and retaining the right people for the right roles in the right market, but what we found through that, when you allow people to come to work and be themselves, I call it bring your whole self to work, not only do we get a better return on their investment, we get a better return on the investment made in the market, and because of the authenticity of people being able to bring themselves to work, and the business that we capture through that is significant. It makes it much more authentic exchange. Through that process of deepening relationships, by getting to know people and allowing them to bring themselves to work, we capture a bigger share of that. So I was having a conversation earlier when I got here during the networking, and one of the questions was, we're talking about diversity and how do we handle the different segments, and do we subdivide those out? And somebody asked what PNC's position was. Our position is very simple. We simply will not tolerate any form of discrimination against any employee of our bank, period. It's a simple message, it's clean, it doesn't require a great, and I know HR likes to write a lot of stuff. Got HR people in the room. But the bottom line is there is no discrimination, period, for any group. And that's a good place to be for us, and it translates very nicely. So when I look at our organization, we're not only committed through what we provide from a health benefit perspective in 2003, but we continue to push the envelope on how do we continue to provide and stay ahead of the curve. So, I don't want to get this wrong. So we're actively working with Human Rights Campaign for 2016 to make sure we maintain that equality index criteria. That's something that we're really proud of. Now, we missed it 1 year out of the past three. We missed it because there was something we just didn't find out soon enough. But we captured it, we committed to it, and we're working very diligently to make sure that we're able to maintain that best places to work and also to maintain that corporate equality index rating 100%. So I want to share with you some stories that kind of bring this to life. So we understand the why, you got that, right? But we, when I looked at the organization a couple of years ago, I made the decision to join PNC. What was very important to me was not to have the corporate speak, the corporate policy. Of course, I checked that out. So I'm a 25, I've been married for almost 25 years. Actually, that's not true. I've been with my partner for 25 years. And we've been married for 6, 7, or 8, whatever that number is, I'll check the date. Because we got married outside. I'm obviously romantic in the relationship. 25 is coming up next year, which is going to be a very expensive year for me. I can see it coming. But before joining PNC, I reviewed, and it's an amazing organization, but I reviewed the policies and procedures, and then I interviewed a number of folks from around the company to make sure that we actually were walking what we're talking. Found out that that was true and came to join the company, and it's been true ever since, and it's great to have that. But, so that's the reason I came. So hopefully they like that and we're doing a good job. But so it was a hiring decision that I made on the basis of whether I joined this organization or others who have the same amount of policy. But we look at it and read it and bring it to life every day. But I want to talk about an individual that I think is just a remarkable, remarkable example of how we brought this to life. And there's a lady who was hired several years ago over in our Campbell market. And she is, at the time when she applied for the job, she was an openly transgender individual becoming a woman, as a woman. She was vetted, she went through the interview process, she went through 4 panels, and she was selected because she was the best qualified individual. Ashley Brundage, if you know the name, is a financial sales consultant with PNC Bank. Went through the process as a transgender woman, came on board, and last year, in 2015, competing against 700 other individuals in the same category within the company, she was the number one top performer in PNC Bank in that job family. And I have to tell you, when you think about bringing your whole self to work, she, her wife, her 2 kids, she comes into this organization, she has more passion, she has more pride, she delivers her experience every day, and the return on investment for us as a company, we just hired one of the best people that we could have in the market, and we did so with her being completely authentic, transparent, completely authentic. So it's great to see a company that understands the $884 billion spent, but sees that it's so much more than that, because when we connect with the individual at the right level, create a space where they can be themselves, there's a residual benefit that we get as an organization back to the stockholders is a powerful one. So I want to leave you on that we do it not because it's the one, we do it because it's the right thing.